Hallelujah. Welcome to your favorite program once again, Spiritual Reality. I remain your host, Reverend Dr. Bazwari Francis. I want to continue from where I stopped the other time. You can be stronger than the devil. This is the second part of it. You can be stronger than the devil. I'll be reading from John chapter 8, verses 23. It says, and he said unto them, ye are from beneath, I am from above. Ye are of this world, I am not of this world. Hallelujah. This was Jesus talking to the Jewish leaders, that they are from beneath, he is from above. Listen to me, the moment you give your life to Jesus Christ, you are no longer operating from the earthly realm. You are now seated with Christ in the heavenly places. You are now operating from the realm of the Godhead, and that makes you stronger than the devil, stronger than the demons, stronger than the enemies, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Jesus said in this place, you are from below, but I am from above. I am not of this world. Hallelujah. You need to receive that truth. You are no longer of this world. The Bible declares that ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The realm you are now is the realm of God, is the realm of Jesus, and the realm of Jesus is the highest realm in the universe. When you have that consciousness, it's very easy for you to believe in yourself that you are stronger than the devil. So Jesus told these people here, you are from beneath. Even the realm that the devil is occupying, the second heaven, the top heaven is still higher than the second heaven. So you need to believe that you are operating from the top heaven. You no longer operate from the earth. Why? Because Jesus is from the third heaven, the highest realm in the universe, and that is the realm you belong to, the realm that controls every other realm. Do you know when Nebuchadnezzar ran mad for 7 years, when he came back to his senses, he now believed that there is a God that ruled in the kingdom of men. He submitted to the leadership of God. Why? Because he realized that the devil he was serving was nothing compared to the supremacy of God. It was nothing compared to the power of God. He doeth whatsoever he wills in the affairs of men. I want you to have that faith in you that you are stronger than the devil, because you are no longer in this realm. The Bible declares in 1 John chapter 5, hallelujah, verse 18, we know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, and that wicked one toucheth him not. Hallelujah. That wicked one. Who is that wicked one? That is the devil. As a born again child of God, you belong to God, and that is why there's need to live a holy life. Look at what John said in this place. John said, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself. He that is born of God sinneth not. Sin is what has been given the devil power on earth. When you decide to live a life of righteousness, when you decide to live a life of holiness, it is difficult for the devil or his puppies to attack your life. It's difficult for them to destroy you. It's difficult for them to make you afraid. Why? Sin is the link between man and the devil. When Adam lost it in the Garden of Eden, it was due to sin. And that is why you, as a child of God, you must strive to live a holy life. You must strive to live a sinless life. It is possible because Jesus Christ is holy, and the Holy One is living inside of you, and you have the grace to live a holy life. Romans chapter 6 verse 1 says, shall we continue to sin that grace may abound? No, you cannot sin, because you are now a child of God, a child of holiness, a child of righteousness. I want to challenge you, you need to strive to live a holy life, because that is the secret to overcoming the devil. Listen, you can overcome the devil if you live a sinless life. Till I come your way again, I still remain Reverend Dr. Bazaro Francis. And don't forget that Jesus Christ is the chief supreme commander of the universe. Hallelujah.